He's known as the Berlin patient. In 2007, Timothy Brown was living in Germany and battling both leukemia and HIV when a bone marrow transplant not only cured his cancer, but incredibly seemed to cure his HIV as well.
My blood's been tested by many, many agencies. I've had 2 colonoscopies, and they've to test to see if they could find HIV in my colon, and they haven't been able to find any.
Brown's case is rare. The procedure is extremely dangerous and won't work in most patients because the bone marrow he received had a special genetic mutation, which made the stem cells in it naturally resistant to the virus. His doctor specifically looked for a donor with this special mutation, which is only carried by 1% of Caucasians. Even back then, 5 years ago, experts were wary of the word cure, because HIV is known to hide within the body. And sure enough, last month, research presented at an HIV conference said the virus had resurfaced in Brown. Experts disagree if the virus ever left, if he was reinfected, or if the new traces are just from contamination in the testing lab.
So, from a clinical perspective, he's cured.
Regardless, researchers agree that Brown's overall condition is proof of concept, that the battle against the disease can advance beyond daily drug cocktails. And right now, a group of the world's top scientists are collaborating on a common goal, finding a real cure for AIDS. One of those scientists is Dr. Francoise Barré-Sanoussi. She is one of the 2 doctors who won a Nobel Prize in Medicine for discovering HIV.
If we work like in the early years of HIV all together, we can move forward very fast as well for HIV cure.
Dr. Stephen Deeks is also part of this group.
Most reasonable people would say it's at best 50-50 that we're going to get a cure. So we don't want to overhype this. We're excited. We think it's possible. We think it's worth pursuing. But don't expect anything in the near future.
A few very preliminary studies are underway. At the conference, French researchers will report on 12 HIV-positive patients who were treated immediately after being exposed to the virus. And those results were promising.
Now they are able to naturally control their infection without any treatment anymore.
Others researchers are studying a group of infected men and women whose level of virus is undetectable, despite never having any drug therapy. The hope is that someday, what's in those patients might translate to a cure for others.
We might hope to be able to cure a few people within 10 or 15 years. In a sort of cancer treatment, tuberculosis treatment kind of model.
In this discussion, there are 2 ways to use the word cure. One, where the virus is completely removed, and another, where the virus is still present, but the patient can no longer infect others. So far, Tim Brown is as close as they've gotten. Dr. Sanjay Gupta, CNN, reporting.